तो वेलकम बैक इंटरमीडिएट फर्स्ट ईयर स्टूडेंट्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कसिंग अबाउट लॉन्ग आंसर क्वेश्चन। इट ऑफनली केम इन एग्जामिनेशन लेवल। सो दिस आई एम आल्सो एक्सपेक्टिंग दिस क्वेश्चन विल अपियर इन 2021 आल्सो। So that you must put concentration about this question and prepare. And TSBI, Telangana State Board of Intermediate, have prepared basic learning material. So from that, I am going to explaining so that this answer is enough to write in examination to get 8 marks. So this answer is enough so that you must prepare in point wise and write neatly as they given, like that only. Put heading and neatly, appropriately how to write by keeping headings, that is ego operators, central cell, like this. And also you have the picture. So in 8 marks question, maximum 8 marks question answers must carry the diagram. So for diagram, 3 marks, for matter, 5 marks. So diagram is also most important so that you have to keep in your mind to draw the diagram. So this is the diagram. Now let us which question we are going to discuss. So the question is third question in the third unit, that is with a neat labeled diagram, describe the parts of mature angiospermic embryo shock. This is mention the role of synergids. So mature angiosperm embryo shock. So whenever we call mature angiosperm embryo shock, you should keep in your mind this diagram. This is the mature angiospermic embryo shock, which contain total 7 cells. How many cells? 7 cells. 7 cells and 8 nuclei. 8 nuclei. So the mature angiosperm embryo shock consists, it is also called female gametophyte. It consists of 7 cells. How many cells? 7 cells, 8 nuclei. So where are the 7 cells? Now let us take here, towards the chalazal end, there will be 1, 2, 3 cells. So centrally 1 cell, 4. And towards the micropylar end, 3 cells. 1, 2, 3. So totally here in micropylar end, 3 cells. 1, 2, 3. Center 1 cell. 4, 5, 6, 7. Total 7 cells. Now let us take the nucleus. Nuclei. So nucleus is the singular, nuclei are the plural. Total 8 nuclei. So 1 nuclei, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th. 8. So total 8 nuclei. So you must keep in your mind the mature angiosperm embryo shock consists total 7 cells and 8 nuclei. Now let us go to that. The mature embryo angiosperm embryo shock, nothing but female gametophyte. It has 3 parts. Number 1 is the egg operators. Number 2 is the central cell. Number 3 is the antipodals. So now the egg operators. Now you can see the picture here. Egg operators, point wise, they given the matter. So the egg operators usually located towards the micropylar end of the ovule. So now here you can see this micropylar end. Towards the micropylar end, there will be egg operators. We can see this is what I am circling. This is the egg operators where the 3 cells are present. So 3 cells, these cells are called synergids and center one is the egg cell. So now this is the egg cell. So whatever I'm drawing the with red, this is the egg cell. Now the whatever I'm drawing circling yellow color, these synergids. So total in egg operators, how many cells are there? 3. Here they given the 3 cells grouped together at the micropylar end constitute the egg operators, and there are 2 synergids now. So this one and this one, both are so now this one and this one are the synergids. So total two synergids and one XL. Now this one is the XL. The synergids with special cellular thickenings, the synergids with special cellular thickenings at the micropylar tip is called filiform apparatus. So you can see here at the towards the micropylar end, there will be a finger-like projections. We can see at the mouth of the synergids. These finger-like projections at the mouth of the synergids are called filiform apparatus. Filiform apparatus. They may help to attract the pollen tube towards the egg cell. And the middle largest cell is the egg or oospore. Now the central cell and between synergid cell is called egg. So now let us go to the now the central cell. So you can see the central now here it is the central cell. The central cell, it is the largest cell in the embryo shock and it has two nuclei. These nuclei are called polar nuclei. So one nuclei coming from upper polar region, one nuclei is coming from lower polar region. So that here what happened? So two polar nuclei, we can see one cell. So one cell, two polar nuclei. Hence the cell is called central cell. The nuclei are called polar nuclei. The cell is called central cell. The nuclei in which are called polar nuclei. Polar nuclei. So both nuclei combine to form diploid secondary nucleus. Two nuclei kalichipoyi oka diploid 2n nuclei erpadutund anamata. Haploid plus haploid equal to diploid. So two nuclei kalichipoyi diploid nuclei secondary nucleus erpadutundi. So ikkada meer gurtu pettukunedi ante central cell ni central cell ki polar nuclei ani pn secondary nucleus ani kuda antamu. Perlu baa gurtu pettukovali. Central cell, polar nuclei, secondary nucleus, three names baa gurtu pettukovali. So next which is antipodals. So antipodals are located towards the chalazal end. Here now I will show you diagram. Now antipodals, I will show you diagram there. So here antipodals are there. So upper towards the chalazal end, there will be three cells are called antipodals. These after fertilization, they may disintegrate and disappear. So the antipodals function, there is no function. They may disintegrate or disappear after the fertilization or before fertilization. Antipodals will be disappear and disintegrate. And next main important aspects of synergids now here. So there will be here they given the in the question, what are the role of synergids? So synergids are located. Now I will explain here. So keep in your mind the picture. These are the synergids. Now what are the functions? Now I will explain. So these are the synergids cells, total two. So here the role of synergids, now I will explain the role of synergids. The synergids cells are present either side of the egg cell. Egg cell ki iruvaipula untayi. Ee synergids mukhyanga female gametophyte ante egg cell ki mari female gametophyte ki food materials andisthayi. New cells nunchi teeskoni. న్యూ సెల్స్ అనేటువంటి టిష్యూ నుంచి ఫుడ్ మెటీరియల్ తీసుకొని ఫిమేల్ గమిటోఫైట్ కు నరిస్మెంట్ అంటే న్యూట్రియన్స్ అందిస్తుంది. ఏవి అంటే సినర్జిడ్స్ సెల్స్. నెక్స్ట్ దే హెల్ప్ ఇన్ ద అబ్జార్ప్షన్ ఆఫ్ న్యూట్రియన్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ది న్యూ సెల్స్ ఇన్ టు ది ఎంబ్రియో షాక్. సో they may absorb the nutrients and supply to the embryo sac from the new cells. Next, most important, they play an important role in guiding the pollen tube towards into the egg cell. So ante kaakunda indaka cheppam filiform apparatus synodist lo untundi adu em chestundi ante general ga akada pollen tube ni towards the egg cell ga vachetattu attract chestundi. So kabatti synodist yokka function mukhyanga rendu rakalu cheppochu, okati embryo sac ki food material andinchadam, rendavadi pollen tube ni egg cell vaipu prayaninche vidhanga cheyadam. So this is the role of synergists. This is most important examination level. You must practice and write appropriate neatly. So you can write the answer. So already I said for this question, this question generally already you know that it is the 8 marks question answer. So total from the 8 marks are 3 marks for diagram. So this diagram 3 marks, this diagram is the 3 marks. You can easily draw, you can easily practice it. Already I said the embryo sac have the 7 cells and 8 nuclei. This point also you should add. So for this diagram 3 marks, for matter 5 marks, total 8 marks. So this answer, the matter, especially this this question matter, I will kept in this video description YouTube, and also you can read easily matter, you can read easily. You should click the in this video description and get this this question answer. So except diagram undadu, kevalam matter maatrame description lo kanipistundi kabatti meeru easyga mobile lo chadukovadaniki easyga untundi matter. So diagram meer separate ga practice cheyandi.